Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. My topic for today is absolute liability. The concept of absolute liability evolved in India after the case of M.C. Mehta versus Union of India, famously known as Oleum Gas Leak case. This is one of the historic cases in the Indian history. The case of M.C. Mehta is based on the principle of strict liability, but with no exception were given, and the individual is made absolutely liable for his act. It is based under this principle that the defendant won't be allowed to plead defense if he or she was at fault, as it was laid down in Ryle and Fletcher case. After the Bhopal gas leak case, many people lost their lives and suffering from some of the fatal diseases through the generation, and because of this there was an urgent need to develop a rule under strict liability which had no exceptions available to defendant to escape from the liability. The rule laid down by the Honorable Supreme Court of India is much broader with respect to the rules laid down the House of Lords in the case of Ryle and Fletcher. It was propounded by Supreme Court that where an enterprise is engaged in a hazardous or inherently dangerous activity, and if any harm results to anybody on account of the accident in operation, the enterprise would be held strictly and absolutely liable to compensate to all those who are affected by the incident. The essential elements of absolute liability are dangerous thing, escape, non-natural use of land, mischief. Dangerous thing, as per the rules laid down, the liability of escape of thing from an individual's land will arise only when the thing which is collected is a dangerous thing, that is a thing which likely causes damage or injury to the other people in people in person or the property or its except. Escape, anything which has caused damage or mischief should have escaped from the area which was under the control of the defendant to come under the ambit of absolute liability. Like it happened in the case of Ryle and Reed versus Lyon and Co. But the plaintiff was working as an employee in the defendant's company, which was engaged in manufacturing silage. Non-natural use of land. Water collected on land for the domestic purpose does not amount to non-natural use of land, but if one is storing it in large quantities, like in reservoirs, as it was the case of Ryle versus Fletcher, then it amounts to non-natural use of land. Mischief, to make the person liable under this principle, the plaintiff at first needs to show the defendant had done the non-natural use of land and escaped the dangerous thing which he has on his land, which resulted in the injury further. In the case of Charing Cross Electric Supply Company versus Hydraulic Power Company, the defendant was assigned to supply water for industrial works, but he was unable to keep the mains charged with the minimum pressure that was required, which led to the bursting of the pipeline at different places. Thank you.